Hi Digmates! Our goal at Dygma is to make your life easier.
You're welcome.
That's why we put so much time and effort into making our keyboards super easy to configure. Forget all the hassle of compiling and downloading the firmware, or putting your keyboard in bootloader mode to flash it. You open Bazecor, our configurator software, make some changes, press save, and voila! Your keyboard is updated, and it works both in wired and in RF mode. However, good is never enough for us. What if you could do that while your keyboard is connected to the computer via Bluetooth? That's something that's never been done on a split ergonomic keyboard before. Well, after months and months of hard work, we finally have the stable release of Bazecor 1.4, which lets you do precisely that.
Am I dreaming?
But that's just the tip of the iceberg. Let's walk you through everything new. The first thing you'll notice is the keyboard manager. Here, you'll see your connected devices. If you don't see your keyboard, press Scan Keyboards, and it will appear. If you have more than one Dygma keyboard, lucky you. This keyboard manager is also great for seamlessly switching between them. If you don't have a Dygma keyboard yet, don't worry.
But I want it now!
You can play around with virtual versions of our keyboards to get a feel for the features and prepare your layers for when you finally get one. Once you get it, you can load that configuration into your keyboard and you'll be up and running in seconds. Okay, now choose the keyboard you want to edit and press Configure. It will take you to the layout editor. Here's where you can easily edit your layers. You can change keys, create combos and dual function keys, assign keys to navigate your layers, and much more. By default, you do that in the standard view, which has explanations for the different features. Once you get the hang of it, you can try the single view, which is more compact and faster. We've also added a small quality of life improvements to this view. If you try to leave without saving your changes, a pop-up will warn you, and you can discard or save them. Next up is the macro editor tab, which also has a few upgrades. For example, the macro recorder now represents the inputs in your configured language. Before, it showed the equivalent in English. We've also added a clear macro button, and this is very useful when you want to redo or maybe reuse a macro. To top it off, we now have buttons to navigate to the beginning and the end of a macro. This is handy when you have long macros. If you want to learn how to make the most of your macros, check out this video with 13 time saving macros for your keyboard. And remember, once you create a macro, you have to assign it to one of your layers for it to work. Now, let's check the Superkeys tab. Superkeys let you create keys with up to 5 different functions. Tap, hold, tap and hold, double tap, and double tap and hold. For example, you can create a super key that does control copy on tap, control cut on hold, and control paste on double tap. In this new Bazecor 1.4, we increased their functionality by allowing layer shift on hold and modifiers on tap, which can be useful for modifiers like the Windows key. To use these features, you need to update your firmware to 1.2.7 on the Defy and 1.0.11 on the Raise. And talking about firmware updates, let's see what's new there. Actually, we can't see what's new because all the work has been done underneath the hood. So although it looks the same, we have completely reworked the firmware update code to make the whole process more robust. We've also added a failsafe so your layers are always restored after updating the firmware. And in case the failsafe fails, we've set a warning to tell you that your layers haven't been restored and that you can restore them in the preferences menu. Speaking of the preferences menu, we've redesigned it from the ground up so it's more intuitive and easy to use. It's now split into two different categories. The first one is the device settings, where you can configure your typing preferences for dual function keys, super keys, and your mouse keys. You have the LED settings like brightness and timeouts, your battery management settings, the RF settings, like the intensity of the radio signal, and some other advanced features, like setting up your default layer. And the second category is the global settings, where you can configure your app preferences, like the appearance of the language of the key layout, and manage your backups and neurons, which is handy if you have multiple Dygma keyboards, as you should. And that's it. You can download the new Bazecor 1.4 at dygma.com/bazecor. Remember, you can use it even without a Dygma keyboard. Please try it out and let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Of course, we'll keep working on improving our software and firmware with more frequent releases. If you want to know what that will include, you can check our development roadmap at dygma.com/roadmap. Even better, you can subscribe to our channel, and I'll tell you all about it in another video.